Today, we are going to talk all things Sales Hub. First, we're going to talk about prospecting and all the strategies to actually convert more leads. Then, we'll talk deals and how Sales Hub helps you actually close more of them. Finally, we'll end on the thing that every manager, every leader wants to know, and that's coaching and measuring their team's success. I'm Alex, and this is How to HubSpot. By the way, you can get started with Sales Hub for free. Just hit the link in the description below. Now, let's get started. This is the HubSpot Smart CRM. What it's gonna do, it's gonna connect all of your data, your customers, and your teams all in one place to make things really easy and unified for your teams to work out of that same shared customer view. If I head over to HubSpot here, I can click on CRM, and I can click on Contacts. This is going to be a view of all the contacts your company has associated with. Any leads, any accounts, any people that may have deals, you're going to find them all right here. Now, if we click into a contact, we can engage with that person and see all the records that are associated with them right there. Let's pick one really quickly and go ahead and click in. And here we can see all of the activities, the emails, the calls, and anything that's been associated with this particular contact, making it easy for your teams to work off of one unified view. Another great view here that you'll want to check out is the company view. If you go over to the CRM and we click on companies, you'll be able to see a list of all the companies you or your company has engaged with in your CRM, making it really easy to get on the same page as the sales team. One other thing that you'll want to check out is the connected inbox. It's just like the company view and the CRM view in that it allows you and your teams to all be on the same page when you're working with customers. Now, let's get into Sales Hub. Let's say it's first thing in the morning and marketing hits you up and says, hey, we've sent over some of the hottest leads from our latest conference and we need you to follow up immediately. Or maybe you get to your desk and you have a long list of calls and tasks and emails to get through. Either way, you know that prospecting, the art of both getting and converting leads, is critical to your sales process. Not only does Sales Hub make it easier, it also brings together all of the tools like calling, emails, and tasks that you need to do your job better in one centralized place. So it can actually help you prospect a bit smarter. To access the workspace, I'll head over to the workspaces icon right here and click on sales. Here I can find the sales workspace and it's collected all of my calls, my emails, my tasks, any to-dos I may have, and even LinkedIn activities that I have to complete all in one place. If I scroll down, I can see a collection of these things called guided actions. Now, what's really nice is that guided actions are going to use some of the intent data in your CRM to start to help you prioritize and recommend the different actions you need to take to get you through the day as a sales rep and have a little bit of success. So we talked about those leads earlier. Let's see what marketing sent over. So you can see we have a little icon here that says new leads have just been assigned to you. I'm going to go ahead and click reach out. Here, I can see all those leads that marketing sent over earlier and I can begin to work them. Now, let's go back to all my leads. If I go back to the summary right here and I click on the leads tab, I can see all of the different open leads that have been assigned to me, making it really easy to see where my prospecting's at. Now, let's click into one of them and do a little bit of prospecting ourselves. So we'll click into this first lead right here, and we can see that this lead is a new lead that just came to me. The important thing that I want to see in Sales Hub, though, is where does this lead stand in my pipeline? So if I come over to the stage, I can see we have a couple. We have new, we have attempting, connected, and qualified when the lead is ready to buy. What we'll want to do is engage with this lead, whether that's calling, emailing, setting up meetings, enrolling them in sequences, and working them to progress them through that journey. Say we went ahead and sent them an email. If we did, the stage would advance to attempting. And as they engage with us, as they reply, things would move along and we would get to connected. Now, finally, the part that I think we're all waiting for is when does this lead actually become a deal? If we go back into HubSpot, we can click on the stage and we can qualify this lead. Now, what we're gonna do here is walk through all of the different information we know about this lead. You can see from the deal creation menu, we can see the pipeline, the stage they're at, the currency, and anything we need to know. Now, once I create that lead, Sales Hub is gonna automatically pull that into my deal board as a deal, and all the information that we had on this lead will be available there too. Now that I've showed you how to manage your prospecting inside of Sales Hub, how about I show you how to save a little bit of time using AI? So I mentioned the connected inbox earlier. One of the really cool tricks that I learned with HubSpot is that you can actually work out of your favorite inboxes already, like Gmail or Outlook. So let's actually head to my Gmail and we will open an email here. So you can see my Gmail looks a little different. My blue button's turned orange and we've got the Sales Hub extension installed here. And what this has done is bring all of those great tools from Sales Hub directly into my inbox. Now let's say it's early in the morning, I haven't had my coffee yet, and I don't exactly have the energy to write that cold intro email. I can use HubSpot to actually write that for me. And here's how. I'll click on this little write an email for me icon and it'll bring up the content generation menu. And what we're gonna do is use it to help us draft an intro email. So let's go over here. I've selected the email type as introduction. And for this example, I'll be selling solar panels, popular as I'm from Florida. Now, who are we selling to? We would just put the customer, our target audience, put all that information in there. And then in a few words, we want to describe why what we're selling appeals to this audience. So I'll add a few notes here. And then also, and my favorite part, we get to select the tone of the email. Now, I don't know about you, it's Monday morning. I'm more feeling professional yet witty at the same time. So we'll select both of those tones and we will hit generate. And HubSpot is gonna make you something wonderful. You can see here, we've got a nice email. The subject line, it's pulled in what I've been telling it. And I can go ahead and click on it and insert content. And right there, I can send that email. So this is a great trick to use if you don't have that time to generate intro emails, follow-up emails, and just help you draft content. We talked a lot about prospecting though, and manual outreach. What if you need to automate some of that outreach and do more of your prospecting motions at scale? Let's go back into HubSpot. I wanna show you a quick trick here. So we'll pull up HubSpot, and we will navigate over to this tab called Automations, and we will click on Sequences. So sequences are a series of automated emails and manual steps like calls and tasks and LinkedIn reminders that help you really engage your prospects at an automated pace and take them through a journey instead of you having to do that one-on-one manual outreach. So let's show you how to build one. So if I want to create a sequence, I can just come and hit create sequence and I can hit create sequence again. And you can see I've been taken to this menu where I can build this sales campaign. Let's start with some initial steps. So remember how I said that this would be automated outreach. What we wanna do is begin to add emails that engage our prospects over time. We wanna start at a more high level and then gradually get closer to that CTA of ultimately booking a meeting or trying your product. So, got a few email templates already built. Let's add some in. First one here, we have a nice follow-up email template. You can see it's pulled in all of the contact information, so it'll be personalized as it's sending. Let's go and add a few more. I typically, for sequences, like to add two or three emails to engage the audience. So I will add one to this reply thread, and then I will add another one as well for a final email. Let's see, I think three emails is good enough. And so that is the automated outreach that our prospects are actually gonna receive. Now, what happens if they engage with that outreach? We wanna take action. That's what we can do here in a sequence. So if I come over to the other side, we'll see this column that says rep-led outreach. Now, this is one of my favorite parts, I think, of Sales Hub, because this is where you can really customize your follow-up and how you wanna handle the people and the leads that are interested in what you're selling. So let's say for this sequence, we will trigger this follow-up when someone either opens the email or when they click in the email. If they do that, let's start to set some dynamic follow-up steps. So first for this one, I think I wanna create a task to research the company. So I'll come in here and I will just add a quick note. So that way, whenever someone does engage, I'll be able to quickly get up to speed. We'll add a couple more. I think we will do an email task so we can send them an email on LinkedIn. And then finally, once we've done that, I like to give the person a call and see how interested they really are. So I'll create a task to call right here and I will click add. And there you have it. I just built a dynamic and personalized sequence that will help me engage my prospects at scale and keep the content relevant for them. All right, now that we've talked leads, let's talk deals. You can track and engage all of your deals in Sales Hub just like you can for leads. So if I go over here and I hover over CRM and I click on deals. Now I don't know about you, I prefer to view my deals in the deal board view. You can change that here by jumping in and clicking on view your deals on a board. And here you can see all of the different deals that are associated with my company. I can see the different stages. I can see the deal amounts and where they're at in my pipeline. Want to explore a deal? I can go ahead and jump into one right here. And just like with leads and with contacts, we can see all of the different activities that are associated with this deal all in one simple view. So I know anyone who's working on the deal will be able to see what everyone else has done, making it really easy. Now let's say I need to move deals around, progress things through the pipeline, and switch things up. Let's go back to our deal board, and I will move a deal around. So let's say I closed this deal. I can bring it over from this stage to closed one, and Sales Hub will automatically update all of the deal information so we know exactly in the pipeline where deals are moving. Let's talk about customization, because this pipeline probably doesn't match the pipeline that you're seeing in your day-to-day sales world. We can customize almost anything in here, which is one of the things I love about Sales Hub. So let's check it out. If we head over here, we will click on settings and we will scroll down to data management. We will hit objects and then we will hit deals. So here is where you can set up your deal pipeline. What you want to do is take the time to make this match your sales process. You can change stages, you can set approvals, and you can really customize this to fully fit the needs of your business. What I like to do is head over to the pipelines tab right here. And this is where I can change all of those different stages. Let's say your business requires a longer qualification period, or maybe they don't, and there's no presentation stage. The nice thing is I can come in here and customize the board to fit my business exactly as I need it to be. Remember that workspace that we talked about? Let's say we've gone through, we've customized Sales Hub, it fits our sales process, and now I'm a rep and I'm ready to work some of these deals. Let's jump back to that sales workspace. So we'll go to workspaces and we'll hit sales. All right, just like we had leads earlier, we'll wanna go over to the deals tab. This is where at a high level, I can see all the deals that are associated with myself inside of Sales Hub. Wanna click into one of these here, I can see a bit more information. So at a high level, we can see the deal stage, where it's at, the amount, the different activities, but I want to point you to two cool areas that you'll want to pay attention to help you get up to speed on where deals are. Now, the first is deal score. This is going to rank your deal on a scale of 1 to 100 with how likely it is to close based off of the information in your CRM. As you can see, 26, I could be doing a lot better here, so I probably need to engage this deal a little bit more, but it's going to tell you what are some of the key factors as to why this deal is sitting at this score. Even below that, HubSpot's gonna use some AI, and it's gonna take a look at the deal. It's going to take a look at your CRM, the contact, the company, and kind of give me some information about, hey, why is this deal not performing well? Here I can see we haven't had an activity on this deal in quite some time, and I can engage them right from here. One neat trick that I want to show you is if this is not enough information for you, you can actually ask HubSpot anything you want to know about the deal. So if I click ask a question, Copilot is going to open up and it's going to start to tell me about this deal. I can ask for the latest time the deal has been engaged. I can ask it to tell me information about the contacts on the deal. I can ask it to tell me about the company. So anything you need to know, you can request from Copilot in here, making it really easy to get up to speed quickly. So now that I've asked HubSpot AI all I need to know about the deal, we've done some work on it, we've made some calls, we've had some demos, I think it's time to close this deal. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll exit out of HubSpot AI here. I will grab my deal and I will actually come here and I will close the deal. So the deal's been moved over to close one. All right, so we just closed the deal. Hard part's over, right? All we have to do now is collect payment. So let's head over to HubSpot. We will scroll down, click view record here, and we will see all the information we need to know about this deal. What I want to do now is scroll down on the side and I want to find quotes. Click add, and from here, I can easily create a branded, really nicely polished and beautiful quote that I can send to my customers and actually collect payment, making it so easy to collect payment and exceed your quota. What good is a sales tool if you can't measure your success? Sales Hub has so many out-of-the-box reports as well as custom capabilities to help you make sure your business is on track. Let's take a look at a couple of my favorites right here. So we'll head into Sales Hub, head over to Reporting, scroll down and click on Sales Analytics. Here you can find all of the different pre-built reports and tools that come with Sales Hub to really help you measure your business. I want to show you, though, a couple of my favorites. If I come over here and I click on the little arrow next to sales, and then I go down to coach reps and teams, one of the first ones I want to show you is the prospecting activities report. Earlier in the video, we talked so much about the ways to move the needle on lead management. Here's where you actually go and measure the results of those emails, those calls, and the different sequences that you're working on. So within this report, I can come down and see things like the average time it's taking to book a meeting. I can see sequence performance by team, and I can even go down and see efficiency. If I click into these different tabs, I can see the same view for things like meeting and calls and tasks. One quick cheat sheet here is that if you have someone asking for these really robust custom reports, you can actually go in here, take a look at a pre-built one just like this, and pop open this sidebar on the side and customize the report to fit your business and make this work for you. Another one I want to show you is all about reporting on your sales velocity. Let me explain. So if I go back into HubSpot, I click on sales outcomes, and I click on the little carrot, I can click on this report called sales velocity. Now we all know closing deals is important. Closing large deals is even more important, but also how long it's taking to close the deal is a critical piece that managers and leaders are looking at, right? So what this report is going to show you is the sales velocity. So the pace at which deals are moving through your pipeline. So if you're looking for a really good top-level metric that's gonna make your business stand out and I think make you look pretty smart, head over to Sales Velocity and you'll be able to see that combination of time to close as well as deal size and the deal amount. Here, it'll show you how your reps are performing. It'll show you how long it's taking them to close the deal, everything you need to know about how effective they're being. One more thing I wanna show you, and that is coaching. You have to get down on the rep level. And we have to look at the calls that people are making, see how prospects are engaging to our messaging and our products in the wild. You can do that in Sales Hub. It's really, really cool. If you head on over to Sales Hub and you click on this library icon right here, scroll down and hit coaching playlists. This is, if you've enabled call recording, where you will be able to see all of the different calls your sales teams and you have made. And now I know we've all had that moment on a sales call where hindsight's 20/20. We go back and we think, oh, I could have worded that differently. I should have positioned this project. This is where you want to take a look at that. All right, let's dig into one of these sales calls. So I'll take a look at my discovery call I just ran here. And from here, you can see that HubSpot has parsed through the call. It's looked at the different terms, it's looked at some call stats, and it started to analyze how this call actually went. Now, I don't always have time to sit there and listen to all of my calls. That would make my work week like 80 hours. But what I can do is ask HubSpot AI to summarize the call for me. So if I come down here and click summarize call, I can quickly see that HubSpot is generating a summary of how the call went. We can learn more about it, that pricing was discussed, that competitor products were bought up. I can quickly get an idea of how this call went without having to listen to the whole thing. One more thing I want to note is that if you're a manager, or if maybe you're training new sales team members, you can actually come in here and click add to playlist, and you can add snippets, the whole call, and different sections of the call to a playlist and help walk new reps or different people through maybe what went well and what didn't go so well on calls, ultimately building up some of the training that you have for reps. So that's how you can review your calls, get actionable insights, and make your calling better. And there you have it. That is how you sell smarter with Sales Hub. If you want to try out some of the tools and Sales Hub for yourself, click the link in the description below. I'm Alex, this is How to HubSpot, and I'll see you next time.